The derby. Now we stay with football news. French Liga 1 side Montpellier have activated the release clause of Mamelodi Sundowns winger Keegan Dolly, leaving him free to discuss personal terms with the club. It seems like the saga of his transfer away from Kleurkop has finally been completed, and Montpellier had matched all conditions relating to his 25 million rand buyout clause earlier today. Joining us on the line, SABC News senior sports reporter Vele Mbuliveza. Welcome to the show. I know you've been running up and down. Rumour had it, Keegan Dolly headed to the airport earlier this evening, making his flight out to France. Can you confirm that for us?
Good evening, Jobe. Well, I can tell you that Keegan Dolly is still in the country. He has not left yet. Maybe if he's leaving, he's leaving tomorrow. But what is clear is that according to our sources, yes, the buyout clause was activated yesterday. 36 hours ago, early in the morning, that's when the 1.7 million euros amounting to over 25 million rands on the current exchange rate. That's what was met by yesterday. So now it's only all the formalities that have got to be done. In fact, Sundowns today, Keegan Dolly, he trained with Sundowns yesterday, and he went again this morning. Even though he didn't train with the team, he said his goodbyes. He was given his passport by the club, and also his locker as well. He cleared his locker as well. So all indications are that the boy is heading to France, where he will link up with Montpellier. Obviously, when the two clubs have finalized the issue of the transfer fee, the next point becomes the issue of the personal terms.
Let's track back a little bit, Velile, because for me, it smacks off one of those scenarios we've been talking about over the past couple of weeks. Sundowns holding on, wishing for something bigger. The reality of it is they were never going to win the case, hence Keegan Dolly taking them to arbitration or disciplinary hearing about his transfer clause being tampered with, etc., etc. Just in a nutshell, round up for us how that went, and Sundowns obviously seeing that they're not going to win it.
Well, what has since happened is that you will recall that the player was bought from Ajax Cape Town in 2014, and then Sundowns immediately loaned him back to Ajax Cape Town, and then there was an issue that Sundowns was demanding a buyout clause of £1.5 million, was earlier they had agreed on around 733,000 euros. So now the issue, when the player was moved to Sundowns, in fact, when he finally moved to Sundowns the following season, something had to change in terms of the date on his contract, and then there was this mix-up as well with the buyout clause. And then when the offer came last year from Olympiacos, there was this problem with the issue of the buyout clause, because Olympiacos had paid 750,000 euros, and Sundowns was demanding £1.5 million. And then there was a problem between the agency and Sundowns. Sundowns ended up going to the PSL dispute resolution chamber, where eventually, I think in December, Sundowns ended up winning the case for the ratification of that contract to take it back to £1.5 million. And that's why Sundowns has been demanding £1.5 million.
Yeah.
And now the player is being sold for that. Yes, I understand that Dolly's camp has since appealed, and they are going straight to arbitration for this. But the reality of the situation is now is that the deal is being done on Sundowns' terms.
Yeah.
And there's where I disagree with them, especially on the issue of this being paid in a lump sum, because it's not something that usually happens globally.
Yeah.
But, well, look, the indication from Sundowns is that irrespective of all the other challenges or difficulties that they have, but they want to release the boy.
Yeah. Quickly, Velile, we're running out of time. Just to wrap this up, Keegan Dolly off to France, Montpellier. He's going to be mixing it up with the big boys, PSG. It's going to be, it's a crack. It can only augur well for South African football.
It's a big thing. It's a big thing, Chobe. I mean, this time last year, we released Kemet Erasmus as South Africans to study Rennes, but he's battled for game time. But if you look at how the clubs have been active in bidding for Dolly Olympiacos and Montpellier, and you look at the process of him doing well there. In fact, I even understand that even Kemet Erasmus will be loaned to a different team, maybe by tomorrow, you know, so that he can get game time there. So now we've got to have Erasmus, we're going to have Dolly in French Ligue 1, and we're still going to have Lebo Motiba, the under-23 international, in the same league, you know. So this is something to look forward to, and this is one of the things we need. We need our best players to be playing in Europe, not because we glorify Europe, but Europe is where the best players are. So you need your players to compete against the best of the best.
Yeah,
we look forward to who will win this AFCON. It will be a team that has got majority of its players playing in Europe.
Yeah, Willem Bulli, SABC senior reporter, speaking to us there on the line, giving us the latest updates as far as the Keegan Dolly saga is concerned. Vele confirming to Sports and Prime that Keegan Dolly is set to leave for France tomorrow evening, and wishing him the best of luck, and hopefully he signs on the dotted line for Montpellier and we're seeing him play in the top leagues of the world.